commentator put in from thee is even the Lord Jesus Christ. The from need not be there, and the word and should be translated even. Signifying that the Lord Jesus that the Lord Jesus Christ is God our Father. The way they got it written, it would seem like it's coming from two different people. But it's only one. Grace be to you and peace from God our Father, even the Lord Jesus Christ. Read.
Blessed be the God.
Blessed be the God.
Even Father.
Even Father. Of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Who have blessed us.
Who have blessed us. With all spiritual blessings.
In heavenly places.
In heavenly places. Now, if we look at this carefully. The Lord is speaking to the church. He's not speaking to everybody. He's speaking to the saints. As this is addressed to the saints of Ephesus and the faithful in Christ Jesus. The faithful in the church. This is addressed to them. This is addressed to us that are baptized in Jesus' name and filled with His Spirit. This is not addressed to every church. Every church is not in the body. I used to hear that when I was working on a daily job. We're all in the body. Well, I couldn't explain it, but it just irked me. That is, it didn't hit me right when they said we're all in the body. That was when the Baptist said it, the Church of God in Christ, and the different ones said it, we're all in the body. No, we're considering all the, we're not all in the body. Everyone that is baptized in Jesus' name is in the body. All those that are filled with the Spirit has the Spirit of God dwelling in them. But we're put into the body, or born into the body, being baptized in the name of Jesus. And we have to be very conscious of this, that we are a special person, people. As 1 Peter 2 and 9 says what? What does it say? Somebody preaches. We are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood. As I read this, the more I read it, people say that the Jew is God's special people. The Jews are one that God chose for a special purpose. And that is to bring the Savior into the world. But they were not that royal priesthood. They were not the chosen generation. We have gotten in the church that it's the Jew that God is concerned with. No, God is concerned with the church. from the beginning. In Genesis, with Adam and Eve, God is concerned with the church. When Adam fell, he fell away from God. Well, God had to bring man back to him, because God's going to have him, this man. He's going to have him, this church. Everything God did, even from the beginning, was about the church. That's how come the scripture says, as we read on here, read on, Sister Hope.
According as he hath chosen us
in him
before the foundation of the world,
before the foundation of the world,
that we should be holy and without blame
before him in love. Now, when we look at this as just being a man, we cannot be without blame. But God wants us to be without blame. And he wanted us this way in the beginning, before the foundation of the world. God had staked out man to be special. Not the fish of the sea. Not the animals in the forest. But it was man. There's none that God took such care of as he did with man. God put himself in man when he breathed the breath of life into man. And God's whole objective was to have man perfect before him. Now, with the knowledge of good and evil, it became a difficult thing for us to be perfect, because now we can't do what we're supposed to do. Because the first question when the Lord tells us to do something is what? Don't eat of the tree. Why? And because of that word, it has put our lives in jeopardy. And it cost God his life. It cost God his life. Do you hear me? To deliver us. It cost God his life. That even after he now pays the price, and he steps in to our path to cut us off from death, so that we don't have to pay the penalty of death. Yet we are not satisfied with what he's doing. We're not even concerned. all we can think is making this flesh comfortable. As a child, all we can think of is having a good time, doing what we want to do. Mama says, don't do that. Why can't we? How come we can't? Johnny's mama let him do it. How come we can't? How come I can't? Just as that child is saying, prove to me that you're doing the best for me. Though that child knows nothing, absolutely nothing, that child is going to make you prove that you know something. And because you don't trust God, you can't prove it to the child. He's chosen us before the foundation of the world that we should be what?
Holy.
And without blame before him. How? You know, when a couple, a married couple, finds one side messing around, it's hard for the other side to continue to love. Am I correct? It's hard for the other one to continue to love. Because if you love me, you wouldn't have done what you did. But the other one swears up and down that they love. When we look at God, when we see Jesus and what he has done, he's done everything that we should be before him without blame. And since he loves us so much, what are we going to do? What's that? And when you say take advantage of it, you may take disadvantage of it. Am I correct? And once he shows his great love wherewith he loves us, then we're satisfied. Amen? I can't hear you. Will you be satisfied? But God wants us to be before him without blame. Now that's something. This is God that created man. And down through the millenniums, he has made a way for man to get back to him. Even though man has fallen away from him, he continues, God that is, Jesus, continues to undergird man. He falters, he fails, yet God enters in to open a way where there is no way. The Lord is working harder to save us than we are to save ourselves. We have every example that life is no good to us. That life isn't out there to treat us good. But God has a way, and he keeps telling us, I've got a better place for you. But we said, prove it to me here. And we're not willing to accept God at his word. But that doesn't stop God from loving us. It doesn't cut God off from seeking to deliver us. He is consistently, daily, working on our behalf. Read, Sister Hope.
Having predestinated us.
Now, so many people get this, and they want this predestination to be an individual choice or a predestination of individuals. But God has predestinated us. And we have to understand who us is. I guess I have to go all the way back to teaching again who us is. Us is the church. He has predestinated us. Who is us? Those that will receive the word of God by faith and obey. Those that will accept his plan of salvation. These are the ones that he is predestinating. These are the ones that are predestinated. Corinthians 10. Start at the first verse.
Moreover, brethren.
I would not
that ye should be ignorant. How that all of our fathers
were under the cloud.
And all passed through the sea. And were all baptized. Unto Moses.
In the cloud.
And in the sea.
They all passed through. Understand that. This is another thing about predestination, if we'll pay attention. All of our fathers, as Paul is looking, he's looking at those in that Jewish nation, those were our fathers. Those were our, the church's fathers. They all passed through the flood, under the cloud, and through the sea. Read.
And did all eat the same spiritual meat. And did all drink the same spiritual drink.
For they drank of that spiritual rock.
That followed them. And that rock was Christ.
Now, we have to go back, because I've got to explain to you what rock that was. What rock was that? That rock that God told Moses to strike
that rock. He told him to strike the rock, and out came water. That was spiritual water that God had given our fathers. He's setting us up. God is setting the church up in the Old Testament. That spiritual rock was who? It was the church. Because God set it up because he's going to save his people. Read.
But with many of them, God was not well pleased. For they were overthrown. In the wilderness.
They did not have the Spirit dwelling in them like we do today. And they were overthrown in the wilderness. But God is still setting up the church. That's not the church yet. That's the forefathers. He's setting the church up. He's setting the church up so they'll have something to lean on, something to look to, something to understand that God is working on their behalf. Read.
Now these things were our examples.
Who's our example? The church's example. He's setting it up for the church that the church might understand how much he loves them. He's setting it up. Mom and daddy whipped out behinds. Mom and daddy took care of us. Mom and daddy provided for us. What did they want us to do with that information? They wanted us to raise children that will continue in the same vein. But when we did not take heed to what mama and daddy taught us, what happened? I didn't understand that one. When we didn't do as mom and daddy taught us, our children saw how disobedient we were. And it seemed like we were having fun, even though we were telling them, don't do it. Come on now. You see how God fixed this thing up? Because the children were watching us in what we do. They hear us today. The problem with today is that the church is not following what they have been taught to follow. Read.
These things were our examples.
To the intent.
We should not lust after evil things.
As they also lusted.
Neither be ye idolaters. As were some of them. As it is written.
The people sat down to eat and drink.
And rose up to play.
We're consistently telling our children what we don't want them to do while we consistently what? while we consistently disobey God, yet we want them to follow God. Now, understand this. When they don't follow God, they're going to pay the penalty themselves. But they're going to blame you for not for their failure. It isn't going to help them. It isn't going to help them that they do the same thing you do. But it sure ain't going to get them into heaven by them following your example. Oh, y'all ain't listening to me. Read.
Neither let us commit fornication.
Neither let us commit fornication. As some of them
committed.
Fell in one day.
3,000
3,000 and 20,000. That's how many was cut off in one day. Read.
Neither let us tempt Christ.
As some of them also tempted.
And were destroyed of serpents. Neither murmur ye.
As some of them also murmured.
Destroyed of the destroyer.
Now all these things
happen unto them
as examples.
And they are written
for our admonition
upon whom the ends of the world has come.
Now, these things were written that we should be able to overcome. We want our children to be saved even if we're going to be lost. Right? We want our children to be saved. But our children want to be just like us. Amen? They want to be just like us. They hear us. They listen to us. Although we tell them and tell them and tell them. But they listen and they watch what we do. And they're going to pay the same price that we pay. But God is so gracious that we still don't have to pay that price. God is so gracious. And we really don't have to pay the price. But we don't listen. Read.
Wherefore. Let him that thinketh he standeth.
Take heed lest he fall. Read.
There hath no temptation.
Taken you.
But such as is common to man. But God is faithful. Who will not suffer you. To be tempted above that.
What?
Ye are able. But will with the temptation. Also make a way to escape. That ye may be able to bear it.
In other words, God knows what we're coming into. He knows what we are facing. He knows we're going to stumble. But at the same time, he's fisted. So when we do fall, we haven't got to waddle. We don't have to stay. We don't have to stay there. But he wants us to awaken to truth. He wants us to awaken.
Go to 12:12. Well, start at the first of 12.
Concerning spiritual gifts.
Now concerning spiritual gifts.
Brethren.
I would not have you to be without understanding. Read.
You know that ye were Gentiles.
You know that ye were Gentiles.
Carried away unto these dumb
carried
idols.
Away unto these dumb idols.
Even as ye were led.
Even as ye were led. Just because somebody told you something, you believed it and you walked behind it. Read.
Wherefore, I give you to understand.
I give you to understand
that no man speaking by the Spirit of
no God, man speaking by the Spirit of God
calleth
Jesus a curse,
and that no man can
and
say
and that no man can say
that Jesus is the Lord.
That Jesus is the Lord,
but by the Holy Ghost.
But by the Holy Ghost, you can't really understand who Jesus is, but by the Holy Ghost. God has given us the Holy Ghost that we can get to know who Jesus is. He wants us to know him. He wants us to know how much he loves us. His love goes further than just saying he loves us. Him, you just saying he loves me isn't good enough. Just saying I know he loves ain't good enough. By God just saying I love you ain't good enough. But he's going through every bit of hell to point out that he loves you. Someone told me that Jesus didn't go to hell. He didn't go to hell because of his own doing. That is, because of any wrongdoing on his part. He went to hell because of our wrongdoing. He went there to pay. Hell had to be paid for the sin. The wages of sin is what?
Death.
Death was required because of sin. Either Jesus pays it for us or we got to pay it. Death is going to be paid. Are y'all listening to me? Death is going to be paid. You can even let Jesus pay it for you. Or you can pay it yourself. Now if you want to pay it yourself, all you have to do is disbelieve God's word. And do your thing. That's all you got to do. And if you want to miss the punishment of hell, if you want to take what Jesus is doing for you, all you got to do is accept his love and keep his commandments. But you got to keep his commandments. Not yours. Not what you think. I don't think anything wrong with that. Who asked you to think?
All right.
Huh? Read. I'm almost finished.
There are diversities of gifts.
But the same spirit.
There are differences of administrations.
But the same Lord.
There are diversities of operations. But it is the same God.
Which worketh all in all.
But the manifestation,
the making known of the Spirit,
is given to every man. To profit withal.
God has given the Holy Ghost that we may profit. That we may profit in all. Now you can reject it and not accept it, but that's to your peril. Read.
For to one is given by the Spirit.
The word of wisdom.
To another, the word of knowledge. By the same Spirit. To another, faith. By the same Spirit. To another, the gifts of healing. By the same Spirit. To another, the working of miracles. To another, prophecy. To another, discerning of spirits. To another, diverse kinds of tongues. And to another, the interpretation of tongues.
But all these worketh that one
self same spirit,
dividing to every man
severally as he will.
In other words, God has given you what He has seen that you have need of. He has set you in a place to be fed of His Spirit, that you can overcome the ravages of sin. You do not have to die in sin. I don't care what you've done, what you've been through. The Spirit has come to deliver you. The Spirit has come to fix it up for you. Now, when you turn the Holy Ghost down, you got nowhere else to go. When you blaspheme the Holy Ghost, who are you going to turn to? Come on now. God has given us of His Spirit that we should be delivered. Now, how long you want God to keep on following after you, and you keep telling him you don't want it? Huh? God said, I want to see you. Read, Sister Hope.
For as the body is one,
and hath many members.
All the members of that one body. Being many.
Are one body.
So also is Christ.
23.
And those members of the body. Which we think to be less honorable. Upon these. We bestow more abundant honor. And our uncomely parts.
Have more abundant comeliness. I take this and say it's like makeup. Well, we don't look the best, what we do? We fix it up, don't we? We make it look better. Is that right? So the Holy Ghost comes to what? We don't look so good. But if you allow the Holy Ghost to work it out, it'll make you look better. Read.
For our comely parts have no need. But God hath tempered the body. Together. Having given more abundant honor.
To that part which lacked. Read.
That there should be no schism in the body. But that the members should have the same care
one for another.
And whether one member suffer,
all the members suffer with it.
Or one member be honored,
all the members rejoice with it.
Now ye are the body of Christ. And members in particular.
We have to understand, God is working on our behalf. He didn't start working on our behalf
when I got baptized in Jesus' name. Back in the Garden of Eden, he's working on our behalf. Today, in your stumbling and bumbling, he's working on our behalf, Sister Holly.
Absorbed in our spirit. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. As we look across the congregation, it seems all has been baptized in Jesus' name. Amen. But there may be one on the outside of the door tonight that heard the word of God and want to be saved. We have clothing. Amen. We have water. And we have someone to baptize you in the name of Jesus. For it's the only name under heaven given among men whereby we must be saved. Amen.
Amen.
We're not going for a long time, but we're going to ask the deacons to bring the baskets. They'll be able to receive offering. We're working on the building. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We need to move forward, but we need, amen, more people. Amen. Amen. But God is going to supply our every need. I believe
amen.
That. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. We need more Jesus. Amen.